Yeah, you know, that was me, and that was a few haircuts ago. The Gannet Man, sort of more known as the Mullet Man these days. But in this episode on UltimateFishing.tv is all about fishing, but fishing not as we know it. This one is kind of like spearfishing, but the fish doesn't actually die. It's fishing, but not as we know it. Right here at UltimateFishing.tv.
There are all sorts of weird and wonderful ways to catch fish. So this week, we're heading out to develop some new fishing methods without using a hook or a line. Humans aren't the only fish hunters, so we've taken some inspiration from nature. Just as the seabirds, like gannets, dive out of the sky to catch their fish, we figured we could give that a go too. Or how about the wild bears of Alaska that scoop their fish straight from the water? That's worth a go. Oh,
this is awesome.
What I'm going to do for you is a reenactment of bear salmon fishing.
Or just as a marlin will use its spear to attack a tuna, we thought we could use a spear to get some fish too. So stay with us as we imitate some of the animal kingdom's greatest fishermen. It's fishing, but not as we know. Spearfishing puts the fisherman into the fish's domain. And while a spear fisherman is not as fast or efficient in the water as a fish, the lethal spear he carries is a very effective way of killing fish. Which is fine if you want some fish to eat, but what if you want to release your fish? One of our regular underwater camera operators, Graham Makarith, is a keen spear fisherman. And together, we've set out to see if tag and release is viable for spear fishing. To do this, we first need to develop the equipment to attach a tag to a fish via a spear gun without killing the fish. And at the same time, we're helping out with some valuable research. And here's where we've got to so far.
We have trialled it.
Yes, we have.
Yeah.
Well, we've trialled it. We actually burleyed up some sharks and we went out on the west coast. We put a whole lot of burley in the water. I actually jumped in the water with Graham. We got some sharks swimming around. And that way Graham was able to easily select his target, which was a nice slow swimming shark, fired the spear gun, the tag went in perfectly, and the shark swam off, no trouble at all, with the tag in it. Now, just on that alone, it's kind of got me thinking about spear fishing. Now, do you think that potentially these tag applicators you've got that can go on the end of a spear gun could potentially change the sport of spear fishing where you can in fact release fish?
Well, I think fishermen have been using tags for years now. Spear fishermen haven't.
No.
When you shoot a fish, sort of, that's it. But with this new system, you can get in with a big fish and tag it. Now, I've shot and landed a bluefin tuna.
Yeah.
And last year I went down and I tried to tag one. I got very close to tagging it. But it means you don't have to kill it.
Yeah, absolutely.
And it's a big, beautiful fish. And most people, when they've been in the water with these fish, 90% of the enjoyment is just being in the water with the fish and hunting it, you know? So I'm pretty sure it could change the sport.
Yeah. Excellent.
To spear a big, fast fish like a bluefin tuna with a research tag is tricky because the gun has to be low powered so we don't harm the fish. But surprisingly, it's not that hard to spear a giant bluefin tuna with a conventional high-powered spear gun. That is, so long as you've got the courage to hop into the open ocean with a very big fish. Much larger than a man, these tuna show no fear of us at all, making them an easy target. However, if the tuna is not hit in the spine, it can put up a huge struggle. And several of these giant tuna that have been speared, the spear's pulled out and the line can often break. These tuna are unlikely to survive, so the placement of the shot is vitally important. This tuna has been speared in the sweet spot and killed instantly. The spear fisherman's companions now gather around and stand by as safety men. They can assist if something goes wrong while he dives down to put a second spear to secure the catch. The line that the spear shaft is secured to is a strong bungee cord that is attached to floats on the surface. This system will absorb the weight and the fight of the fish. And once the fight has completely gone out of the tuna, the spear fisherman can then haul the fish up while he is still in the water. The spear fisherman must remain in the water for the entire time to make the catch official under spear fishing protocol. Once within range of the surface, the spear fisherman then dives down and ties a rope around his catch. It is now that we can see a true gauge of the size of these giant tuna. If spear tagging becomes a viable option for spear fishermen, perhaps they will find that it is just as rewarding to see these magnificent fish swim away with a tag. On our quest to develop spear tagging, we've had a lot of technical obstacles to overcome. And now it's time to test our equipment on marlin off the East Cape of New Zealand. We've struck another obstacle. The weather. Bad weather.
Well, we finally got beaten into submission. 30 to 35 knots of wind, a 4 meter swell, it just wasn't conducive for spear tagging our marlin. But there's more to spear tag than just marlin, isn't there, Graham?
Yes, Matt, one option is to just put a conventional tag in. It actually flies much quicker through the water, much better. It's easy to do.
And we're after kingfish this time.
Kingfish, yeah.
Yeah.
Last year I was here and I saw some kingfish over 30 kilos.
And around the point here?
Just on the point here. So today we'll see if we can get a tag into a 30 kg kingfish.
That would be very nice. And once again, it's just nice to be able to, I mean, traditionally with spearfishing, to get a fish, you've previously had to put a spear right through it.
Yes.
And so it's all over for the fish.
That's right.
So doing it this way, you can get your fish, get a tag into it, and it lives. Everyone's happy, isn't that? Isn't that nice?
To help bring the kingfish close enough for Graham to take a shot, we drop hookless lures. And in no time at all, we have packs of kingfish marauding around the boat. And another opportunity to further test our spear tagging system.
The tanker king is behind us, Graham. We're going to drop Graham right in on these kingfish. We can see, look, there's flying fish flying through the air, and the kingies are smashing the hell out of these flying fish. There's some really big ones in motion. You can see them up in front of us here. There's some monster kingies. Look at them go. Tell us as soon as you're ready, Graham. Right in front of us. How'd you get on?
Yeah.
You see any?
I just put a tag in all those kingfish.
You got them?
Yeah.
On film?
Yeah, I got it on film, mate. Your viewers should be able to see it.
System works?
System worked beautifully, yeah.
Beautiful.
So, that's good.
Well, there you go. We did salvage something out of the day. We did spear tag a game fish. So, there you go. We're still on a mission, though. Well, the conditions today are hardly conducive for getting out in the boat and going fishing. To put it bluntly, it's pretty nasty out there off the coast. So we'll see what we can rustle up by jumping in the water just over here.
Armed with our spear tagger and a camera, Graham and I set off towards a point on the far side of the bay. But we didn't get far before we spotted a crayfish. Graham decided that it should come along with us for dinner. The crayfish was attached to the float and we continued on looking for a big kingfish. While we were checking out a large stingray mooching around in the shallows, we spotted a pack of small kingfish through the murky water, but they were out of range for the spear tag. So Graham taps on his gun to make noise. Kingies are curious and attracted to noise and vibration. So the tapping will often make a kingfish come in close to investigate. This time, however, the small kingfish moved off. But soon after, a bigger fish came within range, and Graham took his shot.
Beautiful, well done.
Hey guys, how'd you get on?
Oh, awesome, mate.
Absolutely awesome.
Just out beyond the point there was some wash. I was sort of struggling to keep up with Graham swimming through the wash.
And 30kg interest just comes straight past the point.
Yeah, I couldn't see him. He'd sort of disappeared and I looked down. Thought he must have seen something.
Yeah, well, I went down and I waited and I thought I better wait for you to film it.
So I hope I did get the footage. Yeah, if I did, there was two kingfish there. And you lined it up, nailed the smaller of the two fish.
Off, man.
Yeah, it took off. It's got one of these tags in it now.
Yeah.
So that's going to be fit and healthy and swimming around with one of those.
Yeah.
And you were saying out there that 30 kilo one.
Oh, I'd have just nailed that if it was beer gun. I wouldn't be able to help myself. And that's the problem, you know. But that's why I've developed this tagging system.
Yeah, and so you're pleased though, you had just as good a time.
Oh, absolutely.
Putting that tag in as you would have if you had a spear.
One of my best days spearfishing.
Well, there you go. We had a great time. Saw a great big snapper as well.
Oh, yeah.
So awesome. We had just as good a time. We can select a few smaller fish for a feed, and those big ones can just swim around with a tag in them.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Alaska is one of the world's great wilderness frontiers and home to the world's greatest salmon fishery.
And pretty much with every cast, you'll catch one of these guys.
And that is a fine fish.
Every year, millions of salmon return to the very stream they were born to make a final journey upstream to spawn.
There is literally thousands and thousands of salmon moving up this stream. Now between here and where we were fishing, we saw another 10 streams just like this.
It's these spawning salmon that attract thousands of fishermen from all over the world. But we've left our fishing tackle behind. Instead, we're here to learn from one of the great fish catchers of the animal kingdom that catches its fish barehanded.
Oh, look at the salmon.
From out in the boat, we've been trolling for salmon. We've spotted some black bears, and to the locals here, they're used to seeing bears, but for Kiwis, this is pretty exciting. So we're gonna come up and we're gonna take a closer look, and if they look docile enough, we're probably gonna land. I've got my camo dirty dog sunglasses, so they're not gonna be able to see me. We've seen the bear, well, we saw two bears, and one of them's in the stream here. This stream here, like the dozens of streams all along here, have got thousands of salmon running up them at the moment. It's just an easy feed for the bears. So hopefully they'll be concentrating on the salmon and not too worried about us. I've got my running boots on anyway. You can see him up there in the stream, he's feeding. He's totally unaware that we're here. And this is what he's here for, these things here. It's a pink salmon, obviously an old fish, hasn't made it up the stream. Now, right where I'm standing now, I can see about 50 or 60 salmon just sitting in the calm water there, ready to go up. And we've got the bear up there waiting for them. Oh, awesome. That is a real wild, live black bear. He's just wandering off, maybe he's seen us. That's awesome, awesome. Keep still. Oh, he's eating a fish. He's got his stash of salmon there. Oh, awesome. He's seen us. Doesn't seem too bothered. He is, after all, a bear. What's he got to worry about? He hasn't got a care in the world. He's boss around here. Maybe he's even coming to check us out. And I'm not at all worried, even though he's coming towards us, because I know that I can run faster than Paul and Kate.
Well, that's probably true, actually. You know? Like, this American food's been doing wonders for my body, you know?
Haven't you ever heard of women and children first?
Now, we're sitting in the long grass there, which kind of makes you wonder whether he's now hunting us. Look at these salmon right here. This is what he's here for. He's only a little fella. And maybe he's decided that, well, there's four of us, there's one of him. Hopefully he's not going to get his mama. Yeah. We didn't quite get here in time to actually see the bear flicking the salmon out of the water. So what I'm going to do for you is a reenactment of bear salmon fishing. I've got a couple just here, sitting in the current. I'll be the grizzly bear.
Oh.
there's a whole lot here, look.
Got me a salmon!
Oh, and he's spawning. I'll let him go and spawn.
Go spawn, go spawn.
He did his business on me. Maybe he thought it was his time. It was sweet.
Here is another amazing fisher, the gannet. It dives at high speed and plunges into the water to grab a fish. And that has given me an idea.
Now on the fishing show, we're always looking for exciting new ways to go fishing. Now, this little bit of fishing is something that I've been inspired to do by one of the greatest fishing creatures of them all, the gannet. Now how a gannet catches its fish is it simply flies around, uses its elevation to spot fish, it falls out of the sky and grabs a fish. There's a prolific amount of mahi-mahi, tuna, wahoo and even marlin out here. We're going to go out here and see if we can find one of those fish, and I'm going to jump out of the sky and grab one. Quite simple, really. Well, there, here we go here. Just up in front of us, there's a bit of activity. There is a few birds there. It looks like, you know, it's definitely a school of mahi-mahi on the surface, and there's a bigger fish there that could be a shark. No, it's a marlin. It's definitely a blue marlin. So we've just got to get lined up now, and while the fish is still feeding on the surface, we've got to take our opportunity. Are you sure they're snappers?
Right here, mate, right here.
Oh, mate, I've got to check this out. If we get a few chunks going, oh, and there's karawai as well, feeding on the chunks, looking good. It's really quite neat seeing these snapper, you know, out in the open like this, just swimming around the Burley Trail.
There's a little boat like yours out there, mate.
Boat like
Stoby.
That is ours. That is our Stoby.
It is. Oh no.
The boat's gone. Oh. It's gone, mate. Who tied it on? Who tied the boat on?
That was you, wasn't it? Sure it was you.
No, because I came to check the Burley.
Squid. Must have been squid.
Oh well, we're stuck here now anyway. We might as well have the fish.
Completely cut off from civilization and stranded on Snapper Island, the three castaway survivors would have to provide food and shelter for themselves until they could be rescued. Matt drew on his rock fishing experience and took an early initiative by setting up a Burley Trail. The idea was to attract fish that the trio could catch for precious food. This spot was so secret that the survivors had told no one where they were going fishing, so there was no guarantee of rescue in the near future.
Well, you know, it's really not all that bad being stuck out here on this rock. I've got my mates for company, we're keeping each other amused, but you know, eventually we'll get picked up, but in the meantime we're having a hell of a time. Oh, hello, here we go. Oh, yes!
Yeah! Oh, good fish.
Snapper fatigue tonight again, boys!
Shot, brother.
Sweet.
Oh.
Okay, now something has eaten this tuna head. It's just been slowly swimming away with it. I've only got it just hooked through the nose, so I really got to give him plenty of time to eat it. There he goes, come on, eat it. Oh, he let it go, come on! He's come back, he's got it. Yes! Holy heck! Trav, this is the big one, mate! This is the one! Just got to hold on to it. Just got to somehow hold on to this fish. Come on! It's a nice snapper, boy, I tell you. It's a really nice one. It's got to keep tension on. Grab the trace. Oh shit, broken. I got him. I lost me rod in the water, but I got me fish. There was no way I was letting that bummer go. Look at that. Got me fish and me rod. Oh, made my day. Away you go, mate. There he goes. Look at him down in the kelp. Yes!
We hope you enjoyed this classic episode, but if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.